Good morning, everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about renewable and non-renewable energy sources. In previous lectures, we have already discussed about thermal power plant and hydropower plant and nuclear power plants. So in this lecture, we will discuss about energy sources. What are the energy sources of renewable energy sources and what are the energy sources of non-renewable energy sources? So in this lecture, the learning objective of this lecture is, after this lesson, the student will be able to understand the described sources and uses of energy, define renewable energy and non-renewable energy, provide examples of common type of renewable and non-renewable resources, and understand and explain general ways to save energy and how the solar heat and hydro power plants and wind power wind energy can be used to generate the electricity. And we will discuss about the benefits and disadvantages of renewable energy sources. So these are the learning objective, and student will be able to understand all the energy sources, which is renewable or non-renewable energy sources, and what is the procedure by which we can generate the energy from these sources, right? So in previous lecture, we discussed about thermal power plant. So what is thermal power plant? Basically, in thermal power plant, we were using coal as a fuel, right? And this coal is your fossil fuel. Okay, so the fossil fuel was using to generate electrical energy by changing the chemical energy into mechanical energy, then mechanical energy was converting into the electrical energy. Then we discussed about nuclear power plant, where we were using the uranium. Okay, so uranium is also a fuel we were using in nuclear power plant. But what was the difference between nuclear and thermal power plant? Both are using fuel, but the amount of fuel which was using in thermal and hydro, if we compare both kind of fuel for the same energy generation, the requirement of fuel in thermal power plant is more than hydropower plant. Okay, so these we have already discussed about these plants. Now we will compare these plants by non-renewable energy sources. So let's come to the market scenario. So commercial energy and non-commercial energy. So the energy sources that are available in the market for a definite price are known as commercial energy. Means if you are using electricity at your home, it has a fixed price. Suppose one unit is for 10 rupees. Okay, so 10 rupees is for your one unit. So there is a price which is fixed. So this is called your commercial energy sources. By far the most important forms of commercial energy are electricity, coal, refined petroleum products. Examples: electricity, lignite, coal, oil, and natural gases, etc. So basically, why this is called commercial energy? Actually, what happens, we are using some kind of fuel. It may be coal, it may be oil, or it may be your uranium. So the cost which is coming for this generating electricity, that comes into the commercial energy. So there are some definite price, because there are there are two type of cost which is used for a power plant. One is your capital cost and another one is your operating cost. So once you want to set up the power plant, there are n number of things which is required. Suppose you required land, you required some equipment, and you required some reservoir for the equipment repairing. So there are a large amount which you need to set up a power plant. When a power plant set up, after that you have to operate that plant by using the fuel. And it will depend, the operation of the power plant will depend how much energy you require. Okay, the electricity cost is fixed and you have to pay some amount to get the electricity, right? So these are the commercial energy where a definite market for a definite price are known as commercial energy. Now, non-commercial energy. So the energy sources that are not available in the market for a price are classified as non-commercial energy. Okay, so suppose, for example, you need not to pay a single pie for your sunlight. Okay, you need not to pay a single pie for your wind. Okay, so these are the non-commercial energy sources for which you are not paying a single pie. Okay, so non-commercial energy sources, the energy sources that are not available in the commercial market for a price are classified as non-commercial energy. So non-commercial energy sources include fuel such as firewood, cattle dung, agriculture waste. For example, firewood, agriculture waste in rural areas, solar energy for water heating we are using in now these days, and electricity generation for drying grain, fish and fruits, etc. Okay, so these are the fuel, or you can say energy sources are available for which you need not to pay. So for example, that if you want to generate electricity for a thermal power plant, okay, so you need first fuel, you need the coal, and you have to pay for the coal. But if you want to generate electricity from the solar power plant, you need not to pay a single pie for that. Okay, so the solar energy you are getting, it is free of cost. You need not required any kind of fuel, okay, or to purchase any kind of fuel from the market. Like cattle dung and agriculture waste, it also can be used to generate the electricity. So these kind of electricity sources comes into the commercial energy sources. Now we comes to the renewable energy and non-renewable energy sources, which is very important now these days, where we see the energy crisis. Okay, so first we will discuss about what is renewable energy sources. So the renewable energy sources is energy which is obtained from the natural sources, right? So natural sources, your may be solar power, geothermal power, tidal energy, hydroelectric power. And the most important feature of renewable energy is that it can be generated without any kind of pollution. Okay, so renewable energy is energy obtained from sources that are essential inexhaustible. So examples of renewable energy sources include wind power, solar power, geothermal energy, tidal power, and hydroelectric power. So the most important feature of renewable energy is that it can be generated without pollution. Okay, now we comes to the next category, which is called non-renewable energy sources. So what is non-renewable energy sources? Non-renewable energy is the conventional fossil fuels. For example, I'm taking example again and again, so it will make you understand easily what is the difference between renewable and non-renewable energy sources, right? So the example of fossil fuels are coal, oil, and gas. Okay, so why this is called non-renewable energy sources? Because the renewable energy sources कांट बी डिप्लीट विद द टाइम. सनलाइट इज इंफिनिटी. व्हेन यू गेट अप अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग यू सी द सन. ओके, अगेन नेक्स्ट डे यू गेट अप अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग अगेन यू सी द सन. सो दीज आर द एनर्जी सोर्सेज विच नेवर डिप्लीट विद द टाइम. बट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज, दीज सोर्सेज विल डिप्लीट विद द टाइम. सो नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी इज द कन्वेंशनल फॉसिल फ्यूल्स सच एज कोल, ऑयल एंड गैस. दीज आर द कन्वेंशनल मेथड फॉर लास्ट 1000 ईयर्स. वी आर यूजिंग दीज फॉसिल फ्यूल टू जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. बट एवरी वन नो दीज आर लिमिटेड सोर्सेज ऑन द अर्थ. वन डे इट विल डिप्लीट. वन डे कोल विल डिप्लीट. वन डे ऑयल विल डिप्लीट. वन डे गैस विल डिप्लीट. ओके, सो दीज आर योर नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज. नाउ नेक्स्ट कम टू द व्हाट डू यू थिंक नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज आर विच इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. सो वी ब्रेक इट डाउन इन टू पार्ट्स, नॉन रिन्यूएबल एंड अनदर वन इज योर रिसोर्सेस. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल कंसीडर नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज. सो अ नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज इज अ नेचुरल रिसोर्स दैट कैन नॉट बी रीमेड और रीग्रोन एट ए स्केल कंपेयर टू इट इज टू इट्स कंजप्शन. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर टेकिंग कोल, सो यू कांट इट रीमेड and you can't it regrown. Okay, so once you consume this coal, you can't regenerate or regrown this source of energy. So this is called your non renewable resources. Okay, now next, nuclear energy. So in the previous lecture we discussed about nuclear energy, how nuclear energy is used to generate electricity. So we were using uranium-235, and what we were doing to generate the electricity from uranium-235, we were taking some atoms and the atoms collide with uranium-235 and it again generate some atoms and it divided into some electrons. So this procedure is called fission. And during this fission or this procedure, a large amount of energy was generating. That energy was using to heat up the water, and water was converting into the steam. Then that steam was going to the turbine blades. So when you throw this steam with the pressure on turbine blades start to get rotate, and the turbine is also connected to the generator. So what happened? When you throw the steam to the turbine blade, the turbine start to rotate. So the energy of steam is converted into the mechanical energy. Then this mechanical part, which is your turbine, is connected to the generator. When turbine rotate and at the same shaft, generator is also connected with the turbine. When a turbine rotate, then generator will also start to rotate, and this generator will change the mechanical energy into electrical energy. So you were getting the electrical energy from the uranium. So main source of electrical energy in nuclear fission is uranium. So uranium is also as a source which can, once it is used, you can never generate it again, and it never will be grown. Okay, so we have taken two examples. One is your coal and another is your uranium. So both resources of generating electricity cannot be grown and reused, right? Once it is gone, it is gone. Now, coal, petroleum and gases. So everyone knows the price of petrol is increasing day by day. Everyone knows that the petrol is limited on the earth. Okay, so coal, petroleum, and natural gas is considered non-renewable because they cannot be replenished in a short period of time. These are called fossil fuels. Okay, now I hope you are able to understand that what is your fossil fuel. So fossil fuel means that they cannot be reused, they cannot be regrown, they cannot be regenerated. Once it is consumed. Okay, so these are your non-renewable energy sources, coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. Now first we'll talk about that how is coal made. So it would be better to understand that why coal is called your fossil fuel and why it is limited. Actually, before 300 million years ago, the dinosaur and many game plants died in swamps. Okay, then what happened? You can see that this is your plant, they get dead, and these are your dead plants. When they dead plants get into the earth, the dirt layer will start on their dirt layer will started on dead plants. Okay, so over million of years the plants were buried underwater and dirt. Okay, so millions of years they were into the earth, and there was some temperature and pressure. Okay, so that was this is the scenario that water 100 million years ago. What happened there? The plants, dead plants, due to pressure and due to temperature, converted into the coal, and heat and pressure turned dead plants into the coal. So you can see that these are the rocks and dirt, okay? And the coal, due to earth temperature and pressure, the dead plants and some dinosaurs or some game plants died and converted into the coal. So it took millions of years to convert it in the coal. Okay, now how are oil and gas made? So you can see over here that 300 400 millions years ago there are some water animals. Okay, so tiny sea plants and animals died in the water and were buried on the ocean floor. Over time they were covered layers of silt and sand. Okay, so you can see over here that the plant and animal which were dead before millions of years, they were covered by sand and silt. And you can see over here that 50 to 100 million years ago there is ocean. So over millions of years the remains were buried deeper and deeper. The heat and pressure turned them into the oil and gas. Okay, so today you are getting oil and gas deposits over here. So it converted into sand and silt rock. So today we drill down through layers of sand, silt, and rock to reach the rock formation that contain oil and gas deposits. So I think now you are easily able to understand that what is fossil fuel and how it was made. Okay, so it took millions of years to convert it that trees and some animals to convert it into the coal and oil and gases. So this procedure is very lengthy. It took 300 or millions of years. Okay, after that we are able to get the coal, oil, and gas deposits. Okay, so these are the limited फ्यूल, दीज आर द लिमिटेड फ्यूल, दीज फ्यूल्स आर कॉल्ड फॉसिल्स फ्यूल. ओके, नाउ वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. व्हाट वाज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कोल एंड ऑयल एंड गैस? सो आई थिंक नाउ यू आर एबल टू इजीली अंडरस्टैंड. फर्स्ट डिफरेंस इज ऑयल इज ऑलवेज गेट यू गेट इन द सॉलिड फॉर्म, एंड ऑयल इज ऑलवेज यू गेट इन द लिक्विड लिक्विड फॉर्म. व्हेन यू प्रेशराइज द गैस इट इज ऑल्सो कन्वर्टेड इन टू द लिक्विड फॉर्म. So if now question rise up, if non-renewable energy sources are resource that cannot be remade at a scale comparable to its consumption, what are renewable resource? One day the coal will be finished, one day the petrol will be finished, one day the oil will be finished. Then how will you get the electrical energy? Totally world is dependent on electricity nowadays. Without electricity we are nothing, you are nothing. Okay, so once it finished then what are the other sources by which we can get the electrical energy? So now we come to the point renewable resources. Okay, so now we will discuss what are the renewable sources and why we need these kind of renewable sources. So renewable resources are natural resources that can be replenished in a short period of time. Okay, so solar, geothermal, wind, biomass and water. For example, day by day you are getting sunlight. Okay, sunlight is a solar energy. Geothermal, we will discuss it later, but in brief I will tell you, geothermal means the heat of your earth. You are using the heat of earth to generate the electricity. Wind, everyone knows. Okay, so wind energy, the energy of wind you are using to generate the electricity. Biomass, everyone knows biomass, for example cow dung and the agricultural waste is which is used to generate the electricity. And next it comes to the water. Okay, so these are the renewable energy sources. Now first we will discuss about solar energy. So energy from the sun, the energy which you are getting from the sun is called your solar energy. Now why is energy from the sun renewable? Okay, so renew plus available. Okay, re plus new plus able, it means it has capability to regenerate itself day by day. Okay, so this is called your renewable energy source. Next we come to geothermal. Okay, energy from earth heat. So why is energy from the heat of the earth renewable? Because this is infinity, it will never end. The heat of earth will never end. In the later slide I will discuss how the electricity is generated from the geothermal power plants. Okay, now we next come to the biomass. So what is biomass? We have already discussed that energy from burning organic or living matters is your biomass energy. Okay, so you can see that these energy sources are also infinity. Trees, you can regrow the tree. Cow dung, it is also available every time. And third one is your agriculture waste. So these are your renewable energy sources. Now let's come to the next point, which is water or hydroelectric. So what is your hydroelectric energy? Actually I have already discussed in hydropower plant that the energy of water we are using to generate the electricity, in this procedure there is no wastage of water. Okay, So we have already discussed about hydropower plants. Okay. So energy from the flow of water, the water which is running or flowing, its energy is used to generate the electricity by some procedure. The procedure which we have already discussed in the previous lectures, okay, in detail. So now we comes to the consumption method at international level, national level and state level. So energy consumption, you can see over here there are three four columns. One is your sectors. Sectors, it may be your industry, it may be your transport, it may be your domestic, it may be your commercial, it may be your others, international level and national level, and this is your state level. So what is international level industry? The consumption of energy at international level is your 51.7%, and at national level it is your 29%, and state level this is your 25%. Okay, now in transportation, the energy which is consumed in the transportation of energy which is consumed in the transportation of international level, this is your 26.6%, and the energy which is using and the energy which is using at the national level, which is your 27%. Okay. At commercial level, this is 7.8%. National level, it is 9%, and state level, this is 17%. Others, international level is 0, national level is 5%, and state level is your 8.4%. So this is the sector-wise energy consumption pattern. Okay, so most of the energy consumption is in industry. Okay, after that it is in transport. Third one is your domestic purpose, then it is your commercial purpose, then for your other purposes. So by these rows or data, we can easily compare the consumption of electrical energy. Now, global uses by the source. Now we come to the sources, and we have already discussed about the sources of energy, which may be your renewable energy sources, which may be your non-renewable energy sources. So what is happening? In the non-renewable energy sources, it comes coal, natural gases, diesel and petrol. In renewable and nuclear and hydro. In nuclear energy, renewable energy sources, it is used solar power and biogas and some other sources, which is comes into the renewable energy sources. So the maximum energy which is generating in India just because of your coal, which is 60.8%. Okay, you can see over here, which is 60.8%. After that, it comes to the natural gases. So from natural gases, you are generating 8.4%. Then from diesel, you are generating electrical energy, that is 0.4%. After that, it comes to the nuclear energy, which is your 21%, and hydro energy, which is your 15.3%. Then it is renewable energy sources, which is your 13%. Okay, so these are the sources which we are using to generate the energy or getting the energy. So maximum amount of energy we are getting from the coal, and minimum amount of the energy we are getting from the diesel. Okay, so this is the global scenario of energy which is used. Now we come to the advantages and disadvantages of energy sources. So what is energy sources? We have already discussed there are many kind of energy sources. It may be your fossil fuel, nuclear, solar, एंड अगेन इट कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू रिन्यूएबल और नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज. सो लेट्स कम टू द फर्स्ट इज योर फॉसिल फ्यूल. व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल? इट प्रोवाइड अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ थर्मल एनर्जी पर यूनिट ऑफ मास. ओके, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द थर्मल पावर प्लांट दैट हाउ इट इज जनरेटेड द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी एंड हाउ मच फ्यूल इज रिक्वायर्ड टू जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी फ्रॉम थर्मल पावर प्लांट. ओके, सो इट इज ईजी टू गेट एंड ईजी टू ट्रांसपोर्ट. It can be used to generate electrical energy and make products such as plastic. Okay. Now, next come to the disadvantages. One disadvantage is this is non-renewable energy sources. One day it will be finished. Next is your, when this product is burned, there are n number of gases which is produced and which is very harmful for your atmosphere and human body. So, burning coal releases substances that can cause acid precipitation. Next, it is risk of oil spills. Okay. Now, we come to the next power plant, which is your nuclear power plant. So, in nuclear power plant, very concentrated form of energy power plants do not produce smoke. Okay. Next, produce radioactive waste, which is very harmful for a human body. In fact, the waste of uranium is very, very dangerous to our atmosphere and human body. So it is a very complicated procedure to dispose it waste. Okay, so it produces radioactive waste and radioactive elements are non-renewable. Okay. Now we come to the next point, that is your solar power plant. So solar power plant, almost limitless source of energy, does not produce air pollution, which is the best part of your solar energy. Okay, so it is limitless source of energy. Every day you are easily get the solar energy to produce the electricity. Now it is very expensive to use for large scale energy production, only particular in sunny areas. Everyone knows that if you want to produce large scale of energy from solar, so you need continuous solar light, solar energy. But in some particular areas, solar energy is not continuous. Okay, so this is the disadvantage of solar energy. Now, next we come to the water. So, water is a renewable energy source. It does not produce air pollution. We have already discussed in our previous lecture that how electricity is generated from the hydropower plants. Okay, now dams disrupt a rivers ecosystem available only in areas that have rivers. Okay. So everywhere you can't get the water. There are some particular areas where you can easily get the water, some hilly stations and some like in India, if you check that there are south and eastern area where you can easily get the water resources. Okay, but in Rajasthan it is very difficult to get the water resources to generate the electricity. Okay, so most of the power plant in Rajasthan is wind energy. So wind energy is a renewable energy source, relatively inexpensive to generate, does not produce air pollution. Okay, so only practical in windy areas. Practically it is not possible to get wind all over the all over the, you know, areas, because there is some particular speed after that you can generate the electricity of wind. Okay, सो विंड इज अ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेस रिलेटिवली इनएक्सपेंसिव टू जनरेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डज नॉट प्रोड्यूस एनी एयर पोल्यूशन. नेक्स्ट इज योर ओनली प्रैक्टिकल इन विंडी एरियाज. नेक्स्ट कम टू द जियो थर्मल पावर प्लांट. सो ऑलमोस्ट लिमिटलेस सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी पावर प्लांट रिक्वायर लिटिल लैंड. सो ओनली प्रैक्टिकल एरियाज नियर हॉट स्पॉट्स वेयर यू कैन यूज हीट एनर्जी ऑफ द अर्थ टू जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो द वेस्ट वाटर विच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड आफ्टर गेटिंग इट हीट टू जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इट कैन डैमेज द सॉइल. सो दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ जियो थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स. सो बेसिकली दीज आर योर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ रिसोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी बाई विच यू कैन गेट द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी और यू कैन जनरेट द एनर्जी. ओके बट देर आर सम एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ दीज सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज योर बायोमास विच इज योर रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज. एंड एक्चुअली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू जनरेट अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी फ्रॉम बायोमास इट रिक्वायर्स द लार्ज एरिया फॉर फार्मिंग. ओके एंड सेकेंड थिंग इट प्रोड्यूस स्मोक. ओके सो दिस इज द एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ बायोमास. नाउ वी कम टू द सोलर एनर्जी सोर्सेस. सो व्हाट इज सोलर एनर्जी सोर्सेस. मॉडर्न रेजिडेंशियल सोलर पावर सिस्टम यूज फोटोवोल्टेइक टू कलेक्ट द सन्स एनर्जी. एंड फोटो मीन्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लाइट एंड वोल्टिक इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय ए केमिकल रिएक्शन. ओके सो कमर्शियल रेजिडेंशियल पीवी मॉड्यूल्स. एक्चुअली व्हाट इज पीवी मॉड्यूल्स आई थिंक आई मस्ट एक्सप्लेन टू यू. एक्चुअली पीवी मॉड्यूल्स आर मेड ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइसेस लाइक पीएन डायोड. ओके सो पीएन जंक्शन. ओके सो दीज आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज और पैरेलल टू मेक अ फॉर्म ऑफ एरे. ओके व्हेन सनलाइट गेट फॉल ऑन दीज मॉड्यूल्स इट स्टार्ट टू ड्यू टू थर्मल रिएक्शन द फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन स्टार्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ इट्स कंडक्शन लेयर. ओके सो फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन स्टार्ट इफ यू अप्लाई एनी काइंड ऑफ इफ यू कंप्लीट एनी काइंड ऑफ सर्किट देन दिस फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन स्टार्ट टू फ्लो एंड फ्लोइंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज योर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ओके सो यू कैन से मूविंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज योर करंट. सो कमर्शियल रेजिडेंशियल पीवी मॉड्यूल्स रेंज इन पावर आउटपुट फ्रॉम 10 वॉट टू 300 वॉट्स इन ए डायरेक्ट करंट. इट कम्स इन टू द फॉर्म ऑफ डीसी करंट. सो ए पीवी मॉड्यूल मस्ट हैव एन इन्वर्टर बिकॉज इन आर हाउस एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द प्लेसेस वी आर यूजिंग एसी पावर. सो द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सो यू कैन से द आउटपुट यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम सोलर एनर्जी दैट इज योर डीसी आउटपुट. ओके सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट इन टू द एसी देन यू हैव टू टेक अ इन्वर्टर टू कन्वर्ट दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और टू मेक इट यूजफुल. ओके सो इट रिक्वायर्ड इन्वर्टर्स. नाउ दिस इज द सोलर एनर्जी सोर्स. यू कैन सी ओवर हेयर दैट द सनलाइट इज फॉलिंग ऑन योर सोलर पैनल विच इज योर पीवी मॉड्यूल्स. देन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज स्टार्ट टू फ्लो विच इज योर डीसी करंट एंड देयर इज अ चार्जर और चार्ज कंट्रोलर विच कंट्रोल द बैटरी सिस्टम. दिस डीसी पावर इज स्टोर्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बैटरी ओवर हेयर एंड देन इट इज पासिस टू द इन्वर्टर विच कन्वर्ट डीसी पावर इन टू एसी पावर. नाउ सोलर एनर्जी एप्लीकेशंस. सो हीटिंग सोलर एनर्जी कैन बी अप्लाइड इन मैनी एरियाज. नाउ इट इज वेरी पॉपुलर. सो नंबर वन हीटिंग एंड कूलिंग ऑफ रेजिडेंशियल बिल्डिंग्स यू आर यूजिंग सोलर पावर प्लांट्स. सोलर सेकेंड इज योर सोलर वाटर हीटिंग. थर्ड इज योर सोलर ड्राइंग ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड एनिमल प्रोडक्ट्स. देन सॉल्ट प्रोडक्शन बाई एवोपरेशन ऑफ सी वाटर. देन सोलर कुकर्स. सोलर इंजन्स फॉर वाटर पंपिंग. सोलर रेफ्रिजरेशन. सोलर इलेक्ट्रिक पावर जनरेशन. सोलर फोटोवोल्टिक सेल्स विच कैन बी यूज फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड सोलर फर्नेसेस. सो दीज आर द सोलर एनर्जी एप्लीकेशंस. नाउ नेक्स्ट वी कम टू द विंड एनर्जी सोर्सेस. सो विंड एनर्जी इज ए फ्री रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज. सो नो मैटर हाउ मच इट इज यूज टूडे बिकॉज यू आर नॉट पेइंग मनी फॉर टू गेटिंग द विंड. ओके सो देयर विल स्टिल बी द सेम सप्लाई इन द फ्यूचर. विंड एनर्जी इज ऑल्सो ए सोर्स ऑफ क्लीन नॉन पॉल्यूटेड पॉल्यूटिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. अनलाइक कन्वेंशनल पावर प्लांट्स विंड पावर एमिट नो एयर पोल्यूशन और ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट. राइट सो इट इज अ क्लीन फ्यूल रिसोर्स. विंड एनर्जी डज नॉट पॉल्यूट द एयर लाइक पावर प्लांट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स. सो लाइक थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स दैट रिलाई ऑन कंबस्शन ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल सच एज कोल और नेचुरल गैसेस विच एमिट पर्टिकुलर मैटर नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड एंड सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड कॉजिंग ह्यूमन हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स एंड इकोनॉमिक डैमेजेस डैमेजेस गैसेस. ओके नाउ दिस इज योर द लेआउट ऑफ योर विंड पावर प्लांट दैट यू कैन सी ओवर हेयर एंड ए पर्टिकुलर यू आर इफ यू गेट द विंड एट ए पर्टिकुलर स्पीड इट इज स्टार्ट इट विल स्टार्ट टू रोटेट. दीज प्लेट स्टार्ट टू रोटेट एंड वैन इट स्टार्ट टू रोटेट इट इज कनेक्टेड टू द जनरेटर. वैन इट रोटेट जनरेटर ऑल्सो रोटेट एंड इट विल कन्वर्ट विंड एनर्जी इन टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. नाउ नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज योर जियो थर्मल एनर्जी सोर्सेज. सो जियो थर्मल एनर्जी इज हीट फ्रॉम विद इन द अर्थ. वी कैन रिकवर दिस हीट एज स्टीम और हॉट वाटर एंड यूज इट टू हीट बिल्डिंग्स और जनरेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो इट इज अ नेचुरल पार्ट ऑफ द एनर्जी फ्लो विद इन द अर्थ डेप्थ. नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ द कमर्शियल ग्रेड प्रोडक्शन जियो थर्मल एनर्जी इज हार्वेस्टेड अलॉन्ग localized geothermal systems where the heat flow is near enough to the surface that hot water or steam is able to rise either to the surface or to depth that we can reach by drilling. Next we come to the tidal power which is also very important but everywhere we can't use tidal power to generate the electricity. So tidal power or tidal energy is a form of hydro power that converts the actually the tidal tides which is coming into the sea and anywhere it contains a large amount of energy. So when it comes to the turbine blades, this energy is converted into the mechanical energy and turbine is connected to the generator which convert its mechanical energy into the electrical energy. So tidal power or tidal energy is a form of hydropower that converts the energy obtained from tidal into useful form of power, mainly electricity. So tidals are more predictable than the wind and the sun. Okay, so we will discuss it in detail how tidal power plants works and what is the complete procedure to generate electricity from the tidal power plants. So tides are more predictable than the wind and the sun. Among sources of renewable energy source, tidal energy has traditionally suffered from relatively high cost and limited availability of sites with sufficiently high tidal ranges or flow of velocities, so constricting its total availability. Now this is a simple layout of tidal energy that this is your sea when tides came. This it collide with the turbine. Turbine gets rotated, and this turbine is connected to the generator, which convert mechanical energy into the electrical energy. And when tides go down going out, then it is also converting its mechanical energy into the electrical energy. Next is your biomass energy. So biomass is organic material that comes from plants and animals, and it is a renewable source of energy. So biomass contains stored energy from the sun. Plants absorb the sun's energy in a process called photosynthesis. When biomass is burned, the chemical energy is biomass is released as a heat. So these are the sources of biomass. This is sewage, municipal solid waste, animal residuals, industrial residues, forestry crops residues, and agriculture crops and residues. So these are the big source of your biomass sources, biomass energy. Now, I think now you are able to understand easily what are the renewable and non-renewable energy sources. Now we come to the MCQ. After going through this lecture, you are able to solve these questions very easily. So question number one, which of the following is non-renewable source of energy? So non-renewable source of energy is fossil fuels. We have already discussed. Second question is, fuel used in thermal power plant is fossil fuel in the form of coal. Third is your, in a hydropower plant, the potential energy purchased by stored water is converted into electrical energy. Kinetic energy purchased by stored water is converted into potential energy. Electricity is extracted from water. Water is converted into steam to produce electricity. No, potential energy processed by stored water is converted into electricity. Okay. Now, next one is your, which is the ultimate source of energy. Which one of the following forms of energy leads to least environmental pollution in the process of its harnessing and utilization? So, environmental pollution is basically from the thermal energy. Next question is your, ocean thermal energy is due to energy stored by waves in the ocean, temperature difference at different level in the ocean, pressure difference at different level in the ocean, tides arising out in the ocean. So this is basically from temperature difference at different level in the ocean. Now, the major problem in harnessing nuclear energy is to how we have already discussed, it is very difficult to dispose of spent fuel safely because it is very harmful to your human body. Now, the main constituent of biogas is, the main constituent of biogas is methane. The second last question is, the power generated in a windmill is more in rainy season, doesn't matter rain is coming or not, depends on the height of the tower, depends on wind velocity. It's depend on the wind velocity. If wind velocity is high, or generating power from the windmill will be also high. Last question is, nuclear energy is derived by combustion of atoms of uranium-235. Obviously, we have already discussed that the fission procedure is used in nuclear power plants to generate energy but through the uranium-235. So this is all about your basics of renewable and non-renewable energy sources. Hope you will understand easily by this lecture that what are the energy sources which is present on the earth. So if you have any problem, you can ask me in the next lecture. Thank you.